slightly surreal, actually. It's a job I've thought I'd never ever, I never thought I'd be in a suit or whatever this is, and walking in doing more of an administrative role after what, just being a player, pundit, all of that. But to be honest with you, I've been here a week now. It's been good fun. It's a very different thing, obviously, to what I've ever really done before, but you're managing people and trying to just make good decisions about where English cricket needs to go. It's something that I think about all the time anyway, before I was doing this job, and now I've got a chance to make a difference. I think really it was just, you know, myself, when I was working for Sky, everyone there is very passionate about English cricket and how you want to move it forward. And we've got all these views, and wherever we're talking, wherever we're doing vodcasts, whether NASA, Ath, myself are arguing or debating, it's always, and even off camera, we're always debating what we think we do with English cricket. And I just thought, well, let's get some skin in the game. And you know, the opportunity came up, and I thought, right, come on then, let's see if you can make a difference. Let's see if actually these views we talk about, or I have, let's see if they're actually any good. Well, normally I think in most jobs you probably end up, you know, you probably leave your old job and there's about a month of just getting yourself ready, then you come in and you meet everyone, all of that. I've sort of come in, I sort of said I'd do the job, came in 3 days later over Easter, and then I've ended up sort of, we've obviously got coaches we need to try and get in place, we've got a captain we need to get in place, we've got selectors, got to meet everyone, all of that. But those first three are absolutely top of that list, and that's actually what I know. I know a lot of coaches in the game. You know, I've spent a lot of time, I've spent 25 years dealing with coaches, the ones who work. I've been a captain, I know sort of what makes a good captain. And then the same with selection, all those things. So I've sort of been able to come in, and all I've had to focus on really is the stuff I know about, which has been a good thing, but then I'll have to catch up later on when those positions are in place. Well, to me, it's all about actually, it's about the mentality of your Red Bull cricket in the country. That's what we really need to get right. How we go about it. It's not about whether you're trying to win this series, that series, do things away from home, all of that. Actually, it's about what type of cricketer do we want? What type of cricket do we want to be playing that will actually take care of everything else? When they did it with the white ball, yes, they wanted to win the World Cup. But actually what they did, it was very, very clear what type of player you wanted, what brand of cricket you wanted to play. And that's why that's lasted longer. That's why new players have come in and actually they've been able to continue, and that success has continued really. And we need to do the same thing with the Red Bull cricket. And it's not just the test team, it's throughout our country in domestic Red Bull cricket. The mentality of it needs to change. You've got two very different teams, obviously, and the white ball team, they know exactly what they're about, and all it is really for them is challenging them and actually making sure, you know, what they've been doing absolutely nothing wrong. It's just keep evolving in that. They've got a captain who knows exactly what he's about and what he's doing, and I think everything is in place there to keep that team evolving, really. So it's a little bit more of the same with a bit of challenge, whereas actually the test team is something different. You've got to really start from scratch, and really everyone's got a blank sheet of paper almost, whether that's been players, coaches, all of that. It's like, how do we want to drive test cricket forward in this country? Because there's been a very, very small period of success, continued success in our test cricket, and that's going back a long, long time, you know, and we need to somehow get that to last for longer. I just think it's near impossible to do the whole job, especially if you're an England coach. It's very different, you know, the Australians don't play as much, and other countries, they don't play as much international cricket. And I think for us, we really now, it's becoming too tough a task. You're almost coaching one format, and then in the same time, you're having to pick the next format, or you're having to think about the next one, the white ball tour, wherever it is, and it might be in a completely different side of the world. So it's just not feasible anymore to have one coach doing everything. But I will say, in this whole process, what it's about is just getting the best person. We've just got to get all the best people in either job. And if the very, very best person turned around and said, you know what, I want to do it all, I can do it all, and you're the best, it's like, okay. So it's open, but you know, it's very, very likely that it'll be a split coach. Well, there's a lot sort of made of that, really. I think, you know, it's all cricket, whatever you're doing, and a lot of it's communication. when you get into management roles, it's about dealing with people. For me, it's about getting the right people in, getting the very best people you can, and then you just give them their role, and it's all right, off you go, and your job is to make sure they're delivering on what they say there is. And I don't think that's different in any way, whether you're a captain of a team, whether you're a CEO, whether you're an MD, whatever you're doing. It's just managing people and making sure actually that you're all pushing in the right direction and that everyone's aligned. You've all got your vision of where you want to take it to, and then you go. I just think cricket has been an interesting place over the last few years, and there's a lot of noise, there's a lot of camps, people for this, people for that. I personally would love to take the whole country on a journey with us, really. Actually take them where we want to become the best in all formats, really. We want to become we want this to be the best era of English cricket. We're up there in two of them. It's just one that we need, and we just want to take everyone with us.